Father, keep it this good girl. Allow me to preach what needs to be preached, God. May the word from my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength, my redeemer. Amen. Amen. See, I used to wonder why my elders used to just shout and praise God for no reason. But you don't know what they've been through. You don't know the story they've been through. You don't know somebody's story. Read the Bible and praise God. You don't know how God has healed their heart and watched over their children. You don't know that story. See, my parents used to say, keep your business to yourself, but sometimes you gotta tell how God has saved you. Thank you, Jesus. In just this church, we got so many emphases, but God has healed bodies. But God many times. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. So the pastor read Ephesians 6, 1 through 12 earlier. And I'm going to focus on Ephesians 6, 10 through 12. Ephesians 6, 10 through 12. And I'm going to read from the NIV version. And it says, finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's scheme. For our struggle is not with flesh and blood, but it's against the powers of this dark world and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realm. May the word of the Lord have a blessing to the readers of the word. See, you might be thinking this sermon is about one thing, because the first part of the scripture was talking about children obeying your parents. But I'm focusing on this last part. Take your stand against the devil. My subject today is know your enemy. Know your enemy. See, I don't know about you, but I like watching movies that deal with sword fighting and with dragons and with kings and queens. I just love movies like that, mystical movies. And in those movies, the king is always at war with somebody. And when he's been at war with somebody, he'll make a plan. And he'll plan out what they're going to do in this war. Then he'll send out scouts to go and see about their enemy. He'll want to know how many soldiers they have, what kind of horses they have, if their fort is surrounded, if it's strong, if they're near water, how many ships. He needs to know about his enemy. In a boxing match or in a UFC fight, they watch their opponent. They train, but they also train in knowing their opponent. They want to know how long their arm reach is. They want to know how much their weight is, how tall they are. Are they weak on the left side? Are they weak on the right side? Do they block well? These are things they need to know about their enemy. In football, each team will watch the tapes of the other team, right? And you watch it because you want to know how good their defense is, how good their offense is. You watch it because you want to see if the quarterback is going to be a person that throws the most or if he passes the most. You want to see if they got trick plays. So you want to know your enemy.
Come on.
So even then in business, a new business will try to find out what's going on with other businesses. They want to know how they're getting their customers. What are they doing to keep their customers so eventually they can get their customers? See, the object is to know your enemy. So you can defeat your enemy, or you can be a couple of steps ahead of your enemy in anything in life. The simple question I want to ask you is, do you know who your enemy is? I'm going to ask it again. Do you know who your enemy is.
All right.
And when you ask people that question, most the person they'll say is the devil. But are you sure that's your only enemy?
All right.
That's something you have to think about.
Right.
Because see, if you love Jesus more than anything,
all right,
and you want to obey God and do what he says do, and you want to live a life that is pleasing to God, everything can be your enemy.
All right.
The enemy is anything that is going against and is going to interfere with you loving and obeying God's will.
All right.
So your enemy can be anything.
All right.
In John 10:10, it says the thief comes to only not only steal, kill, and destroy, but Jesus said, "I come that you might have life and have life more abundantly."
Right.
Yet we still gotta fight our enemies.
All right.
Yet we still gotta go through struggles. Yet we still gotta go through trials and tribulations.
Right.
So, since we gotta deal with these enemies, let's discuss these enemies. And I'm gonna talk about three different enemies that you have to know about.
Right.
Right. The first one is Satan and sin. That's together. Satan and sin. See, sin is anything that goes against God's will and God's purpose. God separates from you, but you separate yourself from God. In the original translation in the Bible of sin, it says you miss the mark. And the mark that you miss is the perfection that God has placed upon us in the law of his word. So anything you do can possibly cause you sin. But we don't realize that. See, sin harms our spirit. And it serves a connection with God. And it causes hurt. It causes misery. It causes harm. It causes depression. It causes anxiety. And it causes you to wonder, where is God when God has never gone anywhere? So our first enemy is Satan and sin. Our second enemy is Satan and spiritual warfare.
All right.
Now, if you don't understand that spiritual warfare, you can't even see. You don't even see it coming.
Right.
See, as Christians, when you decided that you were going to follow God, when you sat on that bench in the beginning of a revival, or you walked up to the altar and said, "I give myself to God," that's when the devil started at you. He's sending spiritual demons after you to try to make you just do whatever he needs you to do. See, when you gave yourself, you also gave a part of yourself to the devil too.
Right.
But see, just like we're here in church on Sundays and Wednesdays and whatever days you might go to church, learning about the ministry of God, there are people out there learning about the ministry of the devil.
All right.
And you think it's not real, but there are people who are learning the ministry of the devil. How to kill, how to steal, how to destroy. There are people trying to figure out how they can stop God's will in your life. There are people who worship him just like we worship God. You don't think this is real, but it is, people. And see, the devil's main goal is to make sure as many of God's people go here.
All right.
To make sure you don't have everlasting life.
All right.
To make sure you don't have that salvation and that grace and mercy that God guarantees.
All right.
That is what the devil is trying to do. And we can talk about things and we can do things in church, but the one thing we have to realize is that the only way we can save people is if we speak on the things of God and speak against the things of the devil.
All right.
So our first enemy is Satan and sin. And our second enemy is Satan and spiritual warfare.
That's right.
That's right. Talk with me, because you know how I am.
All right.
Now, the third enemy, you might be wondering, what else can it be? Well, I'm going to tell you. Many of us are not experiencing any type of warfare. I don't think you caught it. There are some people around you who are not going through anything.
All right.
And you wonder why they're not having problems, why they're not struggling, why they have. It's because they have already been defeated.
All right.
It's because the devil is already in their life.
All right.
It's because they've also been the enemy themselves.
All right.
The third enemy in your life is yourself. It's yourself. You're fighting a war for the devil all by yourself. The devil doesn't have to do anything if you're doing it yourself. So again, you are your own worst enemy. And the thing about it is that we don't understand the possibilities that we have. We don't understand the strength that we have. We don't understand the power that we have through God. So therefore, the devil uses that against us. See, the devil knows his enemy. And see, the one thing he wants you to do is to doubt God. He wants you to doubt what God is going to do. He wants you to doubt who God is. And if he can get you to doubt God, you've already destroyed yourself. And see, by doing this, you're denying the power that God has put inside of you. So let me tell you how you are destroying yourself. Because I think some of you haven't realized it. The first way is selling yourself short. Now, many of you have passions, you have goals, you have dreams, and you're smart and you're educated. And there are things that you want to do, but you also have insecurities, you have doubts, you have fears. You let people tell you what you cannot do. You're selling yourself short. The devil even doesn't even have to say, you can't do it. Because you've already said, I can't do it. You've given the devil too much credit. How many times you said, oh, look what the devil made me do. No, it's what you did. You're selling yourself short. I'm sorry, I don't know about y'all, but if I want to go to school, I'm going to go to school. If I want to start a business, I'm going to start a business. If I want to get a new job, I'm going to get that new job. If I want a new home, I'm going to get that new home. The devil can't sell me short for what God has already told me I can have. So you're stopping yourself. The first thing, you're selling yourself short. Second thing, unclear boundaries in your life. You have unclear boundaries in your life. How many of you say yes to everything? How many of you don't realize that you're saying yes to people and things who are not of God? Just so you can keep people happy. Just so you can keep down confusion. You're saying yes to everything. You haven't set boundaries in your life to tell people no when you know it's not right. Everything you do is connected to you. It's connected to others. And it's connected to God. So when you don't set clear boundaries, you're destroying yourself. You're your own worst enemy. You're allowing people to put all this negative energy, this negative mess in your life because you're saying yes. So the first thing is that you have to understand that you cannot allow yourself to sell yourself short. Second thing, unclear boundaries. Third thing, having unsupportive people around you. That's the thing I just can't deal with. And people want to say, ooh, she's so stuck up. Well, ooh, I don't want your negative mess around me. Because one thing you have to understand is you're going to have people around you that see who you are. You're going to have people around you that know who God wants you to be. And they will connect themselves to you because, ooh, that girl going to have some money. Ooh, that man going to be doing something. Ooh, they got this, they got that. They're going to be around you. But when it comes down to it, when you need that support, they ain't done. Or when you need that positive word, all you need is negativity. You're allowing people to be in your life that's not God-fearing. You're allowing people in your life that's not goal-oriented. You're allowing people in your life that's not like-minded like you. You got to let people in your life that are evenly yoked in your life, just like you do in your marriage. Because those people will destroy you. And it's not their fault, because it's your fault for allowing them in your life. So don't sell yourself short. And don't set unclear boundaries in your life. And don't have unsupported people in your life. Fourth thing, repeating cycles. Now, I don't know how y'all think about that, but think about riding a bike. Especially exercise bike. You just riding and riding and riding. You're not going anywhere on the exercise bike, but you're just repeating it. You're sitting on that bike, trying to lose that weight. But you're going nowhere, right? That's how you are with life. Too many of you have cycles in your life that you're repeating that are not worth repeating.
Amen.
Why are you repeating anything that's not going to get you to the next level in your life? Why would you repeat anything that is not going to take you to your next season in your life? Why would you continue to drink? Why would you continue to hang out? Why would you continue to harm yourself if you know it's not going to get you where you need to go? But one thing you don't understand is, while you're doing it, your children see it too. And some of you are doing it because you've seen your parents do it. You're creating a generational curse on your family because you are destroying yourself. The devil doesn't have to do anything. You're stuck and your children are stuck. So the first one, don't sell yourself short. Unclear boundaries, don't set unclear boundaries. Unsupportive people, get them out of your life. And the fourth thing was in the repeating negative cycles. Those are things that you need to do. See, why should the devil do anything when you're doing it yourself? Why should the devil have to go after you when you're going after yourself? How many times you can be so critical of yourself all the time? See, you're causing a cycle that's destroying your family. You're causing a cycle that's destroying you. You're sitting here listening to other people tell you what to do when you should be listening to God. You're calling people on the phone saying, what should I do when you should be praying to God? You're sitting there wondering why you can't get anywhere because you got so many wrong people around you. You're sitting there wondering why you can't get anywhere because you have so much doubt in yourself. But God has given you all the tools and the gifts you need to excel. You're doubting yourself. You're destroying yourself. And the devil don't have to do anything. The one thing you got to understand is the devil has already been defeated. When you understand that your opponent is already defeated, you've won. I remember when my son was playing football, and they were playing this team that everybody said they weren't going to win against. But I remember going out there, taking something to eat, because y'all know my baby like to eat. Yes, I had to feed him like I'm feeding three children. And I could hear the boys inside the locker room just chanting how they already won the game. They already had seen these tapes, and it was like, you know what? Number 23 going down. And I was like, yeah. It was like, Grace, you need to take down number 2 because he hit my nut. He was like, yeah. They were like, the quarterback, he gonna stack him because he think he can run. And they're like, people know they already won the game. But they knew their enemy.
That's right.
They had already watched and paid attention to this enemy. And guess who won? They did. Because they knew what they were up against. So you got to think about that. The devil already is defeated. So why are we worried? Why are we destroying ourselves? If you don't understand who you are in Christ, then you can't understand that you got authority inside yourself from Christ. Which means you can speak out against him. You sit at home and you know he's trying to mess with you, so you can get back safe. You might as well get home back. I used to wonder why my mama was in the kitchen like, just move back. What's wrong with you? She wasn't talking to me. She was talking to Satan because she knew what he was trying to already do to her children. She was already prayed up, and God had already showed her what he was getting ready to do. And she was already telling him, get back, because I already know what God is going to do. That's something you have to understand. See, Jesus' arm, this arm, principles of power. It says in Colossians 2:15, and having four principles and powers, Jesus made and openly triumphant over them. Which means God already won the war. God already won the war. But see, we cannot give the devil's bitch the dream. We can't give him that gas he needs to keep pushing up against our lives because we're already victors. Because greater is he who is within me than me myself. Do you not understand? Greater is he who is within me But God has equipped us with spiritual warfare. He's equipped us with spiritual weapons. See, we can pull down the spirit. We can pull down these strongholds over our families. We can cast out the devil at any time. We got the power to stand against his schemes. We have the power to resist the devil. We have the power to save souls. We got the power to heal. We don't understand that God has given us these weapons against the devil. We got the strength. The strength to keep going. When we feel like we have no more strength.
All right.
We got the strength to get on our knees and pray for our family and friends and make sure the devil can't take over. Right. We got the knowledge.
Yeah.
The knowledge to grow and excel through God.
Right.
We got the strength to never give up.
Right.
We got the strength to never give up.
Yeah.
Do you hear me? You got the strength to never give up.
Right.
When things seem dark, you can't give up. When the devil tells you that your life is over, you can't give up. When you think you lost that game, you can't give up. Because see, it can be right there in that fourth quarter. It can be right there in those last 2 minutes of the game. When God throws you the ball, and you run it on in, and you get that last touchdown. So why are you going to give up? Why are you going to let the devil win? Why are you going to destroy yourself? See, in order to win, you have to fight. You can't give up. But see, God has already assured us of the victory through him. God has already told us what he's going to do. And you can't let the devil have the power. You can't let him think he has the power. You can't let him know he has the power because you've already won through Jesus Christ. See, the funny thing about it is, you don't know your enemy. Because see, the devil's been watching you the whole time.
All right.
Before you were born, he's been watching you.
All right.
See, the devil was God's right-hand man. He loved God so much. And think about it, if you love somebody so much, you know all their business, right?
Right.
You know, I know my ex-husband's social security number, I know when he was born, I know his brother's social security number, I know his mama number, I know everybody's story. That's what you do when you love somebody. I know his credit score. Ladies, y'all better know these men credit scores before y'all marry them. I'm just saying. But I knew everything about him because I loved him.
Right.
And that's the same thing the devil did. He knew everything that God was going to do because he loved him. He's seen the book of life. So your name is in it and he knows what you're getting ready to do. How can I stop them? How can I block them? Can I put that doubt? Can I put that fear in them? But see, the devil knows that Jesus died on the cross.
Yes.
The devil also knows that Jesus rose.
Right.
The devil also knows that Jesus rose with so much power in him. And the devil also knows the same power that Jesus rose with is in us. But do you know? Do you know? Did you know that Jesus died?
Alright.
Did you know that the power that was in him is in you?
Yeah.
I don't think you do, because sometimes you're crying for no reason. Sometimes you're worrying for no reason.
Right.
You're doubting for no reason. You're fighting yourself for no reason.
Right.
You don't even know your own enemy is you.
Alright.
It's time to stop working for the devil. Mm-hmm. It's time to stop letting yourself hurt yourself. Mm-hmm. It's time to understand that, yeah, the devil might be an enemy, but I'm not going to let you be an enemy of, let you make me an enemy of myself.
Right.
It's time for you to stop doubting yourself. If God put something in your mind to do, step out and do it. And see, I can appreciate Ms. Hall for doing that, Ms. Thurman for doing what she did. She stepped out on faith in her own, and people might have told her, no, you can't do it. No, you can't go back to school as your age. Why are you, but she stepped out and trusted God, and getting ready to graduate. Getting ready to graduate. been scared when the doctor told her that she had a heart attack. But knowing how Miss Austin is, she probably still there and laughed. And laughed about it because she knew who God was. She knew that she was okay. It didn't matter if she don't remember anything because she know God had put all that back into her mind. See, you gotta know who your enemy is. You can't doubt.
Yes.
See, I don't know about y'all, but when I think back to the elders and how they used to just praise God, no doubt they knew what they were going through. They barely had food. But they were worried because they knew God was going to make a way. God was going to allow things to happen in your life. Allow God to make you over. If you're hurting yourself, if you're allowing yourself to let wrong people in your life, if you're doubting yourself, allow God to make you over. Allow God to fix your spirit in your heart. Allow God to just create in me, God, a clean heart and renew a right spirit in me. So I can know who you are in me. But I know the power of you in me. Know who team you on. Who team are you on? Because I don't know about y'all. I'm not on the devil's team. I'm not going to destroy myself. I'm on the winning team.
Yes.
Thank you, God. I just want you to stand to your feet. Just stand to your feet. Some of y'all struggling because they hurt their knee. Who you need to get me?
We gotta shake that out.
I want you to just take 30 seconds.
Yeah.
I want you to take 30 seconds and just pray.